Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, I'll be showing you one new directive that has been added in the latest version of Laravel 9. And the name of the directive is pushOnce. So let's get started. So here, this dashboard page, it is coming from this dashboard controller. And I'm just returning this dashboard.index. And here, just looping through the users, I'm getting the users over here. And just looping to the users and showing the name and the last login at date over here. Now suppose let's say we had a user includes over here. I'll just copy this thing over here, and here I'll create one user.blade.php and I'll paste that over here. And now here instead of this, I'll write here include dashboard.user. And if I don't pass anything over here, then it will automatically inherit whatever the thing that is just above it. So this user and loop, I don't need to pass. But if you want to be specific, then you can pass it. Now let us implement some JavaScript over here. I have already included Alpine.js. And now let me just write here script like this. And suppose let's say we clicked on this username, then let us show the name of this user. And in the real case scenario, you can just show a pop-up where you can edit the user whenever you click on this username or something like that. So here, I'll say here, x-init, and I'll say here, user data like this, and here I'll say JS from user like this. And here I'll write a function, and the name of the function will be the same thing. User, not the user E, user data, and here will be the user. And if you are wondering about this JS from, it will convert this our PHP into the JavaScript object. So here will be the user, and we'll return an object from here. And I'll say here handle click, and here I'll say alert user dot name like this. We have passed the user from this user data to here, and whenever we click on this user, so I'll say x dash on click, I'll say here handle click like this. So now whenever I click on this, then it will just do alert, but it is going inside a loop, so it will show here multiple times. We have this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have 5 users, so it will get printed 5 times, but we don't want that. We only want this to be available once. So for that, there is already one directive which is once like this, and I'll write here at the rate int once over here. So now how many times we loop over this user.blade.php, this thing will only be included once. So now let me just refresh over here, and let me show you the view page source. And let me copy this user data, and over here you can see here this script is added over here whenever it is looped the first time, and after every other data it is not added, which means it is only included once. So this was already available before, and you can see here this script is added in the middle of the HTML, and most of the time we want our script to be at the bottom of the page so that all our HTML and CSS are rendered first, and then in the end our JavaScript is executed. For that we want this to be available here at the bottom. Okay, so for that, so here this is the user blade, and here we are in the index page, and it is extending this layout component. So it is here inside this layouts app, and you can see here I have written here stack script, and whatever we push from any component, it will be stacked over here. And now over here in the user, let's say instead of once, we say here push like this, and push will have script like this. And if we do this, then it will add this script just over here, okay, just above this closing body tag. So now if I come here and refresh, then that script is gone over here from here, and then it is added over here. And you can also see here it is added multiple times because there is no once added over here, and before we had to do it like this once, and again here int once like this, and let me just indent these. And now if I again refresh over here, then we'll only get this script once, which means that we had to write this once as well as push. But now there is a new directive that is introduced, which is pushOnce. So instead of once and push, we'll just write here push once like this, and now we don't need this, and I'll just do it like this and just refresh the page. Then you can see here everything is same, the script is only added once. And if I come here and refresh and click on the user, then nothing is happening because okay, here instead of init we'll write here data like this. We should not write there init, it must be data. And if I come here again and refresh the page and click here, then you can see here the name of the user. And again, if I click here on this user, then you can see the name of that user. So the new directive is this pushOnce.